إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, we'll continue this morning with the book Azamat al-Islam, the greatness of al-Islam. And this is by Sheikh Mahmoud Mahdi al-Istanbuli. And he's saying what the meaning is, that part of the beauty of Islam that it declare war against superstition and delusion. Islam deals with reality, and people shouldn't be scaring themselves from things has no reality or no effect or power in their life. Everything in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is behind all causes. And Allah had made certain causes to work. And He did not make things to be reason for whatever that we guess or we assume that going to be a reason. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the eating to be a means of nourishment, to make you healthy. This is a cause Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able and capable to make you content and satisfied without having food. But it's part of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's wisdom and knowledge why He made satisfaction and contentment and nourishment in the food. Maybe part of it is that you praise Him, that you thank Him, that you acknowledge Him. And since Allah created us from dirt, from this earth, so what is suitable to this body to grow and to be maintained is to eat from the things which grow in this land. Nevertheless, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala behind all the causes, but He made means. And we supposed to take this means and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So abandoning the means is not Islam. And the trust in the means by itself is not a Islam. But people had made up certain things to be a means while it's not means. The means can be something that Allah decreed and that Allah informed us in Quran or in the Hadith that is means. As example, recitation of the Quran for the sick person is a means of healing. Okay, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means the Quran to be a shifa, to be a healing for a physical things and for also spiritual means, that for your hearts, from hypocrisy, from shirk, from and from suspicion and things like this. And also, the Quran, it can be read on the people. And the effect and the result, the impact will happen as a result. The person who receiving the healing, or the ruqya, the spiritual healing, what is the person using, and the person himself who is using the ruqya. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the Quran to be a means of healing. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had told us, tadawa wa ibadallah, fa inna Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala ma anzala da illa wa ja'ala lahu dawa. Seek a cure for your illness. Indeed, Allah didn't send any disease, any illness, unless he made a cure for it. Some people got to know it, and some people did not know it. Okay? So, taking the Quran as a means of healing, this is right. It's the right means. But for somebody to take some sins, as example, and put it in a small bag and hanging around their necks, or putting it under their pillow, as example, to heal them or to protect them or to keep the evil eye away from them. This is not something legislated by Allah, neither by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, nor the experience and the lapse and the discovery had proved it. Okay? Some of those scientists, they take certain food and they analyze it and see about certain elements in it, like iron, and tell you in the carrots they have more iron. So they discover this, as example, eating more carrots for your vision to be strong. So because the study had proved, okay? So now for me to take this in a different means, eating carrots as is, or taking pills that made mostly concentrated from carrots, this is acceptable because it's been proved, okay, that it is a vitamin or it is a medicine. But as example, for somebody to take a broom, okay, and hang it in the door, assuming that this broom will keep the evil eye, or will keep the jinn entering the house. So this is called delusion or superstition, or whatever that is this right expression to use. How did you get to this realization that the broom will cause protection from the evil eye or from the jinn? How did you reach to this conclusion? Did Allah legislate it? Did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam legislate it? Not. Did anything you understand to show us experiments and study lab to tell you that this will do such? It's not. Because you could not make experiments in things which you could not see it, and only from the knowledge of Allah, like the unseen, the jinn. How are you going to make exam and test on them? So for somebody to frighten himself or herself, or to find a means of protection is not legislated by Allah. Neither lab or technicality or been proved to be right. This we call now superstition or delusion or non-acceptable reason. And Islam would like to remove all these things from the Muslim life. Because you're scaring yourself from nothing, or you're taking means that is not going to help and make you trust and depend on it, and you're never going to be taken the right direction. But for somebody, as example, to get up in the morning and read Ikhlas, Falak, and Nas 3 times, this is correct means. Yes, we believe in the shayateen, we believe in the jinn, we could not see them, but Allah and His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us about it and gave us a correct means to protect ourselves against them. So now when you get up in the morning and the evening and you read Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ فَلَقْ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقْ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ 3 times, okay? Now this is a proper means and allowable. But for somebody to take a seashell or some sand and make a, or put a special wearing, okay, that this will heal me or will protect me or give me a good luck. So Islam came to defeat all these means and all these sources and to consider it to be part of shirk. So Islam want to free the Muslim from all this delusion and all this misunderstanding and to put their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you found that part of the tawheed is to do the proper means, and while you do the proper means, trusting in Allah. As the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam say, وَإِذَا مَرِضْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينَ, that when I fall ill, He's the one who healed me. So Allah heals you through means. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had legislated this means. So it's proper for you to take this means, but you still you trust in Allah, not in the pills or the injection itself. But you taking it, believing that this means Allah had legislated for you. So for us to go to means that is not legislated by Allah, not experiments been proved to be a means of healing, this is not acceptable in Islam. Islam also, from the beauty of Islam, that made you to be a free person. And that you are a free person in a sense that you're responsible about your action. Allah give you sense. Allah give you mind. Allah give you eyes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided you, send messengers, okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained to you in His book, as well as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about what is right, what is wrong, what is halal, what is haram, what is tawheed, what is shirk. And Allah say, وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ, we've been given man the two ways. Okay, the two paths. You have the evil way and you have the good way. You have the Islam or you have the shirk. So that means you have a choice. As a result of this, you're going to be responsible about your action. Nobody is forcing you. You can go to the mosque or you can go to the nightclub. Both of them exist. And now you're the one who choose to go. You can drink water or you can drink khamr. You choose. Okay? So when Islam make you knowing that you are a free person and you have the capability to see and to think and to realize things, now you could not make Allah as excuse because Allah written on me to do this, now I did it. Okay? As a result of this, we did not stop making salah and say, Qaddar Allah wa ma sha fa'al. What Allah decreed, what He will, it took place. You say this when things already took place. But you did not say, I'm going to go steal, I'm going to rob this bank, okay? And everything is written, and Allah had forced it on me, and Allah had wrote this on me before I come to this life. How do you know what is written in your book? So do not make what Allah knows as excuse for you to break the law. All right? But if a person take his means and make intention to go, as example, to make Salat al-Fajr in the mosque. Now he took all means, put the alarm clock on. Okay? He made wudu, put his coat on, you understand, because it's cold outside while some people using the fans, okay? You can turn it on. So you took all the means to go to Fajr, but as soon you went to the car, you have a flat tire. Okay? Now you're still struggling, try to catch the Salah. Now you open the trunk, you could not find even your jack or whatever you call it. Now here, you took all means which Allah make it available for you, from alarm clock, making wudu, putting your jacket and going out of the house, and something else is strike or is stop you from reaching to the mosque or making the salah in jama'ah or going to the class. Now when the qadr of Allah take place, now this is what I say, قَدَّرَ اللَّهُ مَا شَاءَ فَعَلْ. Why? Because the Prophet صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ had told us, احرص على ما ينفعك واستعن بالله ولا تعجز. Be concerned about anything which is beneficial for you. Okay? Beneficial for me to go to work? Yes, I go to work. Is something beneficial to me according sense and mind that I take the medicine? So you take the medicine. Okay? احرص على ما ينفعك and seek help in Allah. And don't be defeated. Okay? So after you take the means and things did not work, now in this moment you say what? قدر الله وما شاء فعل. What Allah had decreed, what Allah decided, took over. Okay? Now I have no might or power over this. I could not change it. But somebody, knowing that his flight leaving in an hour, taking his sweet time eating a sandwich, and after this, you understand, I'm going to try to drive like crazy madness person and try to leave the car in front of the airport, you understand, rushing and sir, you're supposed to be here before the flight 1 hour. Now, this is your laziness. This is part of your negligence, okay? Although that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that this is going to happen. But we could not be using the qadr and what is written as excuse for us not to do what is right. Does Allah know about things because before it happened? Yes. Did Allah decree it and wrote it down? Yes. But for you, you didn't see it. Allah saw it. Allah know it. So you're supposed to take what is means for you that is available, and after this you leave it to Allah. But don't break the land, and do not put the seed, okay? And after this expecting an apple tree. Same way, like nobody. Yeah, I'm not going to say, yes, I'm going to have a baby, inshallah, okay? You didn't get married, okay? You did not even start to get a job to get married so you can have a place. You are not talking any means. And after this, they say, what? I'm going to have a son soon. All right? So we have to take the proper means towards everything. And the meantime to know that what Allah will, that will happen, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't will, is not going to happen. Every person, as Allah is saying, وَأَنْ لَيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى. And that a human being only gets what he achieves. You don't sit in your house and after this you want to get a reward 27 times prayer. You didn't pray with the jama'ah, neither he made effort to go to the jama'ah. So Allah say, for you, you'll be rewarded for what you achieve, what you struggle to earn. You don't go to work and after this expecting get the paycheck in the end of the month. The same thing like another person who went and was there 7 o'clock in the morning, leave at 5 o'clock. It doesn't work like this. So some Muslims, they use the qadr in a ways that is not right. They apply it to halal and haram, sins and disobedience of Allah, but they did not utilize it in their daily life. When they talk about marriage, talking about children, talking about getting the paycheck, they have a double standard, you understand, how they treat things. The Quran is full, you understand, with verses that talks that a person, what he earn, what he do, what he achieve, that mean Allah give us a means and ways that we can work and we can achieve things. We're responsible about our action. And Allah is saying, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ. That any calamity falls in you is a result of what? The mischief of your hand. So you did bad, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punish you for it. And we have to take the result of what we do. And end with this verse that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, surah number 67, verse number 2, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. The one who had created life and death to test you, to see which one among you is better indeed. Okay? So, Allah created life and death, okay, to be a field for the plant and to see the result. So that means we have ability to plan, to produce, to do things. Otherwise, that we have no choice about anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will decree things, but we shouldn't be talking about what is written in the mother of the book, because we did not see what is there. We take means and do our best, and after this, if things didn't go the way we planted, now we leave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and try again. Do we have ability to change? إن الله لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغيروا ما بأنفسهم. Surah 13, verse 11. Never Allah change the condition of the people until they change what's in their own self. So we have the ability to change. We have the ability to believe. We have the ability to turn away from the mosque. Everything is available. oh. Alright, we're going to stop here, inshallah. Sorry for the disturbance with my coughing. If anybody have any question about what been said this morning, inshallah. Alright, inshallah, we'll close this session. And after this, we have a small discussion this morning. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك. ان الله